Hello friends! In this video, we'll take a look at an original device for a smart home, which, to put it simply, emulates a human finger. It's actually called FingerBot. In its basic configuration, it can press physical buttons, and in the extended version, it has a variety of levers and attachments for pulling, pushing, and so on. The use of such devices allows you to add even those appliances to a smart home that were not initially designed for it, and are operated by physical button presses. By the way, if your appliances can be controlled with a remote, then consider controllers that can send commands via infrared and radio channels. You'll find links to reviews in the video description. Before we begin, please like this video so that more people interested in the smart home topic can find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Device type, FingerBot, finger emulator. Interface, Zigbee 3.0. Maximum lever stroke, 12 millimeters. Available colors, white, black. Pressing force, up to 2 kilograms per square centimeter. Power, CR2 3-volt battery. Edge size, 34.5 millimeters, cubic shape. Operating temperature range, from minus 10 to 45 degrees Celsius. Requires a Zigbee gateway or coordinator. Ecosystem, Tuya Smart, Smart Life, supporting Google Home, Home Assistant. The device comes in a small cardboard box, featuring its photo and indicating the type of wireless connection. By the way, Zigbee versions have appeared not so long ago. Previously, there was only Bluetooth. Directly on the box, there's a small instruction manual showing how to remove the back cover, pull out the battery safety tab, and scan the QR code. Let's take a look inside. It's worth noting the good packaging. I mean the special securing holder for the FingerBot, which keeps it securely in place and prevents it from moving around in the box. In the package, aside from the main device, there were only a couple of square pieces of double-sided tape for its attachment to surfaces. The device has the shape of a perfect cube, with a side length, as I mentioned earlier, of 34.5 millimeters. On one side, there's a lever with a stroke of up to 12 millimeters. Its position and depth of pressing are adjustable. If we consider the side where the lever moves as the bottom, then on the opposite side, the top, there's a touch button. By the way, it's switchable. Pressing it activates the lever. It allows retaining standard manual control. The attachment on the lever is detachable. The standard kit includes a simple pusher. Additionally, you can purchase a set of pushers of different lengths and shapes, as well as rings. There's also a version of FingerBot available in black. For size comparison, it's next to a standard matchbox. The gadget is quite compact. The back cover, relative to the lever, is removable. Underneath, it is the compartment for the battery. In my case, it was included in the package. There's also a reset button and a QR code that leads to the instruction page. For power supply, you need to pull out the safety insert, and the device enters pairing mode. This is indicated by the flashing LED. To activate manually, press and hold the reset button. Let's start with the standard control system, which in this case is Tuya Smart, as usual. Like for other Zigbee devices, a gateway is required for connection. I'm using a wired version with Homekit support. For those interested, there's a review link in the description. The connection process is entirely standard. FingerBot should be in pairing mode, then we enable search on the gateway, and within a minute, it detects and connects to it. The gadget appears in the list of gateway's child devices, and in the overall system list. Let's explore its plug-in capabilities. It looks like a relay externally, with a central toggle button, below which is the current status, followed by additional options. Pressing the button triggers the lever movement. Here's how it looks with default settings. Manual control. Let's move on to the settings. In the first menu, you can adjust the lever movement parameters. By default, the click mode is set. In this mode, the lever moves to the specified depth, from 51 to 100%, where 100 is the maximum. Then, either immediately or after the set interval, it returns back. Additionally, there are two more modes, switch and programmable. For example, the lever movement at minimum depth and at maximum depth. The switch mode differs from the previous one in that the lever does not return back by itself. There are two positions here, on when it's lowered and off when it's raised. These positions can be inverted. Also, there are two depth settings. Upper, the position to which the lever will rise, adjustable from 0 to 50%, and lower, the position to which the lever will descend, from 51 to 100%. Here's how it works. When turned on, the lever lowers to the specified depth. When turned off, it rises to the specified height. The third mode is programmable. It allows you to set a specific sequence of presses. The upper options are the number of repetitions and the initial position of the lever. By default, continuous repetition mode is enabled, meaning presses will occur continuously while it's on. But you can also set a finite number from 1 onwards. Then, you specify the sequence of operations, in which position to move the lever and, if necessary, the delay time in that position. Set the desired number of repetitions, the initial position, and add the required number of operations. I think in most cases there will be 1 or 2. After that, activating FingerBot, including via the button, will trigger the entire sequence. Here's an example of a triple press with a 1-second delay at the bottom and a 2-second delay at the top. A real-world example of using it to control a coffee machine. You can set it for a specific time or action, for example, turning on the lights or starting kitchen activity in the morning. The next option in the main menu is the scheduler. It has two settings options, countdown, where FingerBot will activate after a certain time. Depending on the mode, it will either press, take a specific position, or perform a sequence of presses. And the weekly program, which could come in handy with a coffee machine, for instance. Here you can set the activation time by day of the week, synchronizing it with your schedule. In the special settings menu, you can adjust the parameter that, judging by the name, determines the force of the press. There's also an option for adaptive pressing, which I understand is also dependent on the force of the press. Next is a link to the electronic manual. As we remember, there's no paper manual included, which I think is a good thing. It saves paper, and the electronic version will always be up to date. Settings menu. Everything here is standard, compatibility with external systems, compatibility with Google Home and Amazon Alexa are claimed, shared access, group creation, desktop display, firmware checking, and removal from the system. Let's move on to automations. I'm already used to the fact that literally all Tuya devices can participate both as triggers and actions. Even if the proposed triggers offer parameters that are completely impractical in real-world use. But the hero of this review stands out from this list. It cannot be either a trigger or a condition, but as an action, sure thing. Here, I created a manual automation that can be launched from the app. There are 3 options available: turn on, turn off, and reverse state. In click mode, they will all work the same. The difference will be in switch mode, where the extreme positions are fixed until the next command. This automation, as I mentioned, can be triggered either manually from the app or from another automation. The operating mode is cloud-based. But if a device connected to the same gateway is used as a trigger, then it should be local. Let's move on to checking third-party management systems. FingerBot remains connected to the Tuya Smart Gateway. Let's start with the claimed Google Home. The interaction here occurs at the level of cloud accounts. The hero of the review is found in the list of devices, so the support is indeed there. Here it is displayed as a switch. Depending on the mode set in Tuya Smart, it will either emulate a press with every status change or, in switch mode, take one position or another, or trigger a sequence of presses. Although compatibility with HomeKit is not claimed, let's check it too. The gateway to which the hero of the review is currently connected has been added to the Home Assistant integration called HomeKit Controller. It immediately shows whether the device will work in the native Apple Home app and in Home Assistant itself. And the hero of the review is also present here. It's identified as a standard switch object, which will operate depending on the set mode. There are no settings here, but they aren't needed since everything can be configured in the Tuya Smart app. The important thing is that FingerBot can be used together with Apple HomeKit. Gradually, we've also reached Home Assistant. While FingerBot is still connected to its native gateway, we can check compatibility with the Tuya integration. Similar to Google Home, it operates at the level of cloud account linking. The good news is that the hero of the review is supported here as well. Otherwise, everything is just as it was discussed earlier, a standard switch object with 2 positions on and off. Just to clarify, everything shown up to this point, Tuya Smart, Google Home, HomeKit, and this integration all work simultaneously and do not interfere with each other. And now it's time to disconnect from the native gateway and continue compatibility testing, but this time with alternative Zigbee coordinators. Let's briefly step away from Home Assistant and switch to the local control center from Ulink, Sonoff Ihost. The firmware version tested as of the date of the test is 1.13.3. For the main features, device compatibility test, and installation of additional containers, check out my reviews, links are in the description. Ihost is equipped with its own Zigbee coordinator and can directly work with devices from different manufacturers. FingerBot was detected by the system and connected. Support is there, but only basic, as for a regular switch. Any state change triggers the lever in click mode without delay. It doesn't matter whether it's turning on or off, the response is the same. There are no other settings, and unlike the systems and integrations discussed earlier, you can't configure them in the native app. In other words, you can work with the device, but only with default settings, press and return without delay. It can be used in automations. Unlike Tuya Smart, it can also be used as a trigger, with the switch state being specified here. In actions, there's turning on, turning off, and toggling the state. Remember, in reality, all these actions are the same, pressing the lever. Now let's go back to Home Assistant and check the device's operation in the native Zigbee integration. Another observation, when removing FingerBot from the gateway, it automatically enters pairing mode, which is rare for in-Zigbee devices. Otherwise, everything is standard, although, in my case at least, the interview process turned out to be quite lengthy and took several minutes. But in the end, the hero of the review did connect properly. Let's check what's available with this connection method. And here there's nothing new, a standard switch object, although in addition to it, there's the firmware version checking entity and the battery level sensor. As for its operation, only the standard momentary press mode, which is triggered with any change in the switch's state. There are no settings available. Essentially, working in Zigbee is not different from working through the HomeKit controller integration, which is also local. However, in its case, you can adjust the lever's movement through the native Tuya Smart app. To complete the picture, we need to check compatibility with Zigbee 2 MQTT. The current version as of the test date is 1.35.3. The connection process is standard. I don't see the point in showing it again. The key point is that the device is supported out of the box, and it's recognized specifically as FingerBot. Device information page. Here you can confirm that this is an in device, which is normal for gadgets powered by batteries. It's done to save energy. Expositions page. As we can see, there are many options here, both operating mode and setting the upper and lower positions of the lever, delay, reverse, and disabling the touch button. Moreover, here you can set the upper and lower positions even for the click mode. The upper position ranges from 0 to 50, and the lower position from 50 to 100. This means you don't have to raise the lever to the maximum, reducing its travel. In this example, it's set to only 10%, from 50 to 60 with a 1 second delay. Here's how it looks. For comparison, I set the full range of motion, from 0 to 100%. And here's how it will look in reality. The switch mode here only differs in that the lever doesn't return back but stays fixed until the next command is received. So, the delay option doesn't affect anything. There's also a programming mode here, but when it's set, FingerBot works similarly to the click mode with the full range of motion. You can set the sequence of presses using automations, and all settings, including boundaries and intervals, can be changed on the fly. FingerBot is an intriguing and specific device. I would put it in line with remote control emulators, as it also allows integrating devices not intended for smart home systems. If you have a task related to the need for physical pressing or shifting of a button or switch, it will help solve it. Among its merits, I would mention its Zigbee interface, which ensures wide compatibility with various control systems, compactness, ease of installation, autonomous power, and the presence of its own button. As for drawbacks, I can't say anything at the moment. During testing, I couldn't identify any explicitly negative aspects. However, I acknowledge that they may be discovered during prolonged use. That's all. I hope the video was useful and interesting to you. I would appreciate your likes as they will help promote it on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and tutorials, subscribe to my channel. In the description, you will find all the necessary links to stores where you can purchase this device, to other mentioned reviews relevant to this topic. as well as to my Telegram channel, Facebook page, and group for discussions on smart home issues. Thank you for your attention. Until next time, peace to everyone.